Hollywood.tv here with the one and only king of disco, Boney M. Mr. M, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
We'd like to welcome you to Dubai. Tell us what you think about Dubai.
I love Dubai. I've been here for, I came here the first time when I was a young boy, 28, 29, and see how the place grew up. One of the highest buildings in the world today. So many foreigners from all over the world. It's so beautiful to watch, you know?
Right.
Very beautiful.
We just watched your concert. A lot of love was going on. Tell us a little bit about the people who brought you here and how the experience was for you.
Well, Burdu Kali, they brought me here. First show was a little complicated, a little bit, you know, because I'm very busy in Europe. But I told my agent, say, I'm coming, you know. Yeah, but I said, don't worry, I can do it, you know. He said, but you're getting old. I said, what old? You know what I mean? I'm not a bottle of wine you put in somewhere and take out when you're ready to drink it, you know?
Your career has spanned a lot of years. Tell us a little bit about how long you've been doing what you do and some of the people you met during that time.
Well, I've been in the career since 1976. I left Aruba as a little boy, 15. I used to be a seaman. I scrubbed floors, cleaned toilets, you know, was a waiter and been ups and downs, fall on the ground and rise and, you know, and this is the life, you know. People don't realize that before you want to be a hero, you have to start by the zero. Nobody gonna break up my style. Nobody gonna slow me down. Oh no, I gotta keep on moving.
So during that time, tell us about some of the people who inspired you to do what you do. And when did you know that you really wanted to be Boney M? You wanted to start entertaining?
When I was a kid, I always was a, they always called me the payaso, the joker of the town, you know? And I was practicing and then without their knowing it, you know? So when I came out to the world, I started to realize what I want to do and how I'm gonna do it. And then I come into the business, I see it show and business and meeting people like Muhammad Ali, you know, Michael Jackson, Prince, Bob Marley, who gave me a lot of inspiration, you know, like his song, because I remember when we used to sit in a government yard in Trenchtown, when Georgie will make the firelight, love baby burning through the night. No, Bobby, don't cry.
The something man, he rushed a low blow.
He was big and strong, in his eyes were very blue.
Poor people looked at him with terror and fear.
What a master of chips, he was such a lovely dear. Hey, he could preach the Bible like a preacher.
I see a lot of positive energy around you, and even on the stage, everyone jumped up, everyone wants to dance around you, everybody wants to touch you or be around you. Who inspired you and gives you that same impression, positive energy?
Muhammad Ali. Yeah, he gives me that, you know. I met Muhammad Ali, and he jokes with everybody, you know, and he always comes, hey, you bony guy, where you get this energy from, man? Give me some of it, you know, and he's always been like that.
There's a lot of things going on in the world right now, economic crisis, terrorism going on in India. So what would you say to the world right now? What is Boney M's message to the world right now?
Because by the rivers of Babylon, where we sat down, yeah, we were, when we remembered Zion. carry us away, captivity, require from us a sound. Don't hear, but listen.
Are you ready? Yeah. You want to come and stage and dance with me?
Yeah. There you go. Look. She's crazy for you, daddy. Whoa, she believes in you. She loves you, daddy.
I want to tell a nice time on Hollywood TV. Thank you very much for having you. God bless you, and I hope you take good care of yourselves.
I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart.
Hollywood, as it happens.